Hi, my name is Nora, and I'm a fairy godmother. I just flew in. That's why my hair is kind of messy. Sorry about that. But I wanted to talk to you a little bit about being humble. And the reason I decided to help you with this conversation is because when I help people and I make pumpkins into coaches and I turn mice into footmen, I don't say, hey, look what I just did. How amazing is that? I don't wave my magic wand and then say, aren't I amazing? I am so cool. I'm the best fairy godmother you ever saw. I don't do that because I'm not in it for me. I'm in it to help Cinderella, whoever it is. They need my help. I fly in, I take care of business, they're all happy, and then I fly away. And the reason I have a rose for a magic wand is because I don't want everyone to know I'm a fairy godmother. I would be way too busy helping if I did that. But once in a while, if someone is really in need and they call for their fairy godmother and they're a worthy person, I come down and I turn them into whatever I need to turn them into to help them. But I don't look for the glory because I'm humble. Hi, I'm here with Chaney, who is part of the YMCA Schools Out program, does a great job, and I've noticed that he does a great job, but he doesn't say, I'm so amazing. So I wanted to talk with him about being humble. So Chaney, did someone teach you to be this way, or you just came out this way?
I think my parents taught me a lot. They're both, have great values, and they've kind of passed that along with me. Working with kids, you want to teach them the values that you have. So I wouldn't be, doing my job right if I was bashful or if I was boasting or, teaching them things or behaviors that I wouldn't want to have myself. So, definitely, taught for my parents, in school and stuff like that. So, it's definitely something that gets passed along.
Right. And I noticed you have this Scholars and Stars shirt on.
Yes.
So I was asking if you were cross country or track or sports.
I used to run track back in high school. I was running indoor track, so I ran the 600 hurdles and I threw some shot put. But I'm really excited for Kenny Day today, so I had to, show my Elmwood pride and wear the shirt today.
Of course, I have mine on too. But the question is, were you a star? Were you a great my impression was that you were really good at sports. Is that right?
I mean, yeah, you could say that.
Right. So thinking about Tom Brady, who is a humble athlete. Mm-hmm. I mean, he is the best.
Yes.
But he never says, all about the team and all about, we could have done better. And I remember when he was under Drew Bledsoe, and Drew Bledsoe was the quarterback and he was the assistant, he would always say, Drew is coaching me and mentoring me. It was never about Tom.
Right.
So I'm guessing you are also a humble athlete.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yeah. I mean, everybody plays a part. Everybody has a role in their team. Like Tom Brady, it takes all 52 guys, for a program here to be successful. It's not just me, it's me and my 7 other staff. We all play an important role. So we kind of carry that same mentality in sports that we have here at work. It's just like in the school. It's not just you. It's just not aunts. It's not the teachers. It's everybody, the janitors. Everybody plays their own role, to make school successful. So just like in program, everybody does their part. So.
I'm here with Allie, who's at the Schools Out program at Elmwood School, and we're here to talk about being humble. Now, I know Allie does a lot of awesome things, but I've never seen her brag. I've never seen her make other people feel bad. So I wanted to ask you, how did you learn to be humble, and what do you think about being humble?
Well, I learned to be humble by when my brother used to be really mean to me. Well, he would brag about a lot of stuff. He would say, I'm better at this than you, and I'm better at that, and I knew he was better, but he was bragging about it a lot. And then I once said it because I was like, he can say it to me, and he felt bad, so I was like, then I'm not going to do that, and I'm going to be humble and not make fun of him anymore, and I'm going to be kind to him, and be nice to him and say that he's good at stuff, and he can say mean stuff to me, but I'm not going to say mean stuff to him. And yeah, that's
amazing. Can I just say that's amazing, because that's very perceptive of you. You understood how you felt, so you didn't do it to him. Well, you could have, but you didn't. So that is being humble and wise and kind as well. So in class, have you seen people who are humble, or can you give me an example of someone who's humble in your class, or maybe it's you, and how it helps?
Mm-hmm. Well, someone in my classroom named Callie, if someone's ever like sad, like the other day I was not feeling well, and she was like, oh, she actually texted me and she said, are you okay? Because I didn't go to soccer practice. And she was like, you weren't at soccer practice. Are you okay? I just want to make sure you're okay.
And she would never boast about that. No. She would never say, I'm the best friend because I checked in on you. Yeah. She just does things like that to be kind, but she wouldn't ever call herself out and say, yeah, I agree with you. Callie is super kid. Can you tell me a little bit about how you are humble?
I'm humble because I'm good at a lot of things, but I don't brag about it. Like, I'm good at, like, swimming, but I don't brag to my sister about it because she's not that good.
That's exactly what I was hoping you would say. So you know that you're good at it, and you don't brag to your sister. Why don't you brag to your sister?
Because I know it might make her feel bad that she isn't that good.
Right. So you're humble, but you're also kind and wise because you don't want to upset your sister. So I really appreciate that. And how about in school? In school, when you do well on a test, you hold up your paper and say, I got the best score.
No. I just say, like, I say to myself in my head that I'm really good at it, but I never actually yell it out or tell any of my friends.
That's perfect, Jillian. And so tell people at home watching why it's good to be humble.
So you don't brag about it, and you might not have, like, as many friends, because then they're like, wow, I'm not really good at that, so why be her friend or something?
Right, so they want to be friends with you if you're someone who might compliment them but not put yourself up, right?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
So tell us, how did you learn to be humble?
Well, my parents taught me it's not polite really to brag or ask for things. People have to offer you them, and if someone offers you something, you should do it, and you shouldn't brag, oh, I've done this before, I'm so awesome at it. You shouldn't brag like that.
Great, that's great. And so do you have brothers and sisters?
No.
So it's just you?
Yeah.
So you get all the benefit of their wisdom, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah. So if you could have any advice for the kids watching at home, would it be about why is being humble a good thing?
Well, say someone invites you over to play with them, and you could say, like, oh, well, that's really nice of you. I'll come over in just a little bit, instead of saying, oh, well, I don't know. Should we do that or that? Instead of you suggesting, because it's their house and you're coming over, so they should get to pick.
Wow, so you have really good manners, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, you do.
Well, we appreciate that. We appreciate that you're humble, and we appreciate that you have good manners. So in school, how about in school, if you were going to do something really well on a test or a game, would you brag about that, or what would you do?
No, I'd just say in my head, yay, I got a good score on my test. I hope I get another good score on my next test.
Nice. So you don't make other people feel bad, but you do celebrate in your head. I love that. I'm here with Marley and her mom, Michelle, and we're here to talk about being humble. I asked Marley if she would talk about this with us because she is not someone who I ever see brag. She's always kind and helpful, and that's a really wonderful quality. So Marley, I want to ask you, how did you learn to be this way?
Well, I don't, like, it kind of just comes to me. I don't really, like, practice or anything. But since I have four brothers and sisters, I kind of just get used to the feeling of, because usually when I brag, usually there's a lot of people, so I kind of get used to being nice.
That makes a lot of sense. Yeah. So are you the youngest or the oldest, or where are you in position?
I'm in the middle of three girls, but I have a younger sister, two younger brothers, and one older sister.
Okay, so you're sort of the lieutenant to the oldest.
Yeah, she usually plays with me because I'm technically the closest to her. She kind of thinks the littler ones are kind of annoying.
Yeah, they're kind of babyish, I guess. All right, so you learned, did you learn this? Oh, so you just had this naturally is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, and because you have a lot of kids in the family, you have to kind of get along, along to get along. All right, I love it. And what do you do in school or on sports teams? Like if you were going to get a great grade, what would you do? What would you say?
Well, I'd say that, like, you did pretty well, too. Mm-hmm. Next time you might want to try studying a bit more, but you definitely, but you definitely do really well in class.
That's great. And so what if someone said to you, wow, you got 100? What would you say?
Well, we're both in the same class, so we technically learn the same things.
There it is. Right.
Yeah.
Right. So that's being humble. You didn't say, yeah, I did. Aren't I awesome? You said, well, you know, we're both. So that's exactly right. You don't make the other person feel bad, and you don't make yourself look awesome, even though you are. All right. So let's talk to your mom for a second. So obviously a wonderful kid, and I know your older daughter, too.
Yes.
So how do you do this? How do you, guide them?
My husband is actually really, really good. We talk all the time about where things come from. How did this food get on your plate? Well, Daddy worked really hard to make some money, and Mommy did the shopping, and Mommy cooked the dinner, and we should all be very happy that we have this wonderful food in front of us to eat. Yeah. You know, we try to do little things like that. Manners, please and thank you. We do a lot of that.
I think that's wonderful, being a team and being grateful,
yes.
You know, exactly. Not taking credit for everything yourself, and also, don't get anywhere by yourself, and also helping your kids understand the value and the work it took to produce the food and gather the food and have the money to buy the food. I think that's really valuable. All right, I love that. So what would you say to kids back home watching? Why should they be humble? Why is that a good thing?
Because if you're humble, people like keeping secrets. If someone tells you something, you don't go like blabbing to other people, being popular because you know people's private stuff. If you do that, you'll lose trust. You probably won't have any friends. Mm-hmm. And like if you're humble, then people will like you. You'll get friends and people will appreciate you for what you do.
Wonderful. So they trust you because they know you can keep secrets and you're humble, so they know you're not going to brag. I love that. Thank you so much, Marley. We really appreciate your time. Thank you, Michelle.
Thank you.
I'm here with Pastor Mike Lawrence, who is the pastor at Faith Community Church. He's actually the lead pastor. There are several pastors. And we're here to talk about being humble and why being humble is a good character trait. So I want to ask Pastor Mike, and I really appreciate his time because this is his break, how it feels to be humble and how he learned to be humble.
So for me, humility is something I learned. It wasn't something I had. I wouldn't say I was a humble person. I learned it through role models. One of my role models wrote something that really inspired me when he said, don't push your way to the front, don't sweet talk your way to the top, put yourself aside and help others get ahead. Don't get obsessed with getting your own advantage. Forget yourself long enough to lend a helping hand. Think of yourself the way Jesus thought of himself. So for me, being in ministry, Jesus Christ has been a real role model of humility.
Right.
Here's somebody who impacted lives for the last 2,000 years and has stretched his influence around the globe, mm-hmm. and yet is a role model of humility to me. Mm-hmm. He didn't have to be in the limelight. Jesus even said that he didn't come to be served, but to serve.
Mm-hmm.
I like to say that Jesus is the type of guy, he loved everybody the same, and if your feet were dirty, he'd wash them. So if somebody like Jesus Christ could change the world and by being humble, that was pretty good inspiration for me. I committed my life to that. I committed my life to saying, how can I help other people succeed? And to me, that's what humility is about. What's your need, and how can I help you succeed?
Mm-hmm.
So just identifying whether it's people around the world who need clean water, great. How can we get clean water to them? To you're sad today, mm-hmm. how can I help you feel happy? Mm-hmm. As simple as that. And it really what it takes is you just have to stop thinking about yourself for a few minutes, mm-hmm. pick your head up, look at other people, and identify someone and say, what do you think that person needs? And I find that if you look a person in the eye, you can usually tell if they're happy, sad, or something's bothering them. And most often, when you just go and say, hey, is there anything I can do to help? It's that simple.
I love that. That's what I do at school all the time. When I look around and I see the kid who needs something, how's it going? Are you okay? Yes. Thank you. Who is that quote from? Do you know?
His name is Paul. Sometimes on churches, you might see the word Apostle Paul. He was a great leader in the church. So this is a guy who had a tremendous education, was very successful at what he did, stretched the church in places unknown, and was really driven by humility because he just thought, he didn't see himself as being better than anyone else. He just saw himself as having a call that he wanted to fulfill. And I think in humility, you're thinking, I'm not better than anyone else. So why do I need to push myself forward? If I'm going to do a good job, people will notice it. I don't need to be the one to tell people I'm doing a good job. They'll just notice it.
Right. So he was the humble servant, serving wherever he could find the place to serve.
Exactly. There's so many opportunities right around you all the time. And I find that the more I focus on trying to meet someone else's needs, the amazing thing is the more people meet my needs. And in humility, when I'm helping other people, I'll hit points in life where I need help, and I hardly ever have to ask, because all of the investment I put into helping other people tends to come back towards me. Mm-hmm. God just has built that into life, mm-hmm. and it's just been a way of trying to think and act.
So that's wonderful. Thank you. And it sounds, so kids watching, it sounds to me like if you are humble and you look for ways of how to help others, that people will help you when you're in need. Is that what I'm hearing?
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
Okay. So being humble helps you help others, and then they help you. So it's a win-win.
It's a total win-win.
Thank you so much for your time. Hey, Ready Freddy.
What, Piggy Wiggy?
You know what I heard?
What'd you hear?
I heard a story from Greek mythology.
What?
Mythology. It's a story that didn't really happen, but it helps teach a lesson.
Okay.
So, this is about a guy named King Midas who was really, really greedy, and he wanted money, money, money. And he didn't care what would happen when he got all the money that he asked for.
Oh, really? Money's a good thing.
Yeah, but too much of a good thing isn't always so good.
Okay.
So, King Midas wished that he could turn everything into gold.
Whoa.
Yeah, but the problem was everything he touched turned to gold.
Whoa.
And that meant that when his daughter came running to hug him,
uh-oh.
Yeah, and he touched her.
Oh, no.
Right. She turned to gold. And you know what? If he had been humble,
oh, yeah.
If he had been humble and thought about what was really important in life, simple things like the touch of your child's hand or hugging someone.
Yeah, hugs are nice.
Yeah, so if he had thought about the humble, simple things, and he had been humble, he would still have had his daughter instead of a golden statue.
Oh my goodness. You're right. I think it's good to be humble.
You're right, Brady Freddy. It is good to be humble.
What?
Was work well done. I just helped a princess get her wish. And you know what? I feel really good about that. I don't need to tell everyone what I did when I help people. Because being humble is a reward in itself. If I help people and they're happy or their wish comes true, that's my reward. It makes me happy to help other people. They call on me when they need something. I fly in and I help them. Being humble is a great thing to be. It makes me feel good to know that I help someone else. I don't need to get praise or glory for that. Today we heard from people, puppets, and we read quotes about being humble. Why is humility a good thing? Why isn't it good to talk about how great you are and think you are better than other people? As we heard from many people here who represent a majority of people in life, being humble means you make and keep friends, continue to be successful, and feel good about yourself. Nora, our fairy godmother, is someone who has a lot of power to do things, but she doesn't call attention to what she can do or how amazing that is. If people could really do what a fairy godmother does in fairy tales, it might be a challenge not to talk about their power or talents. In contrast, the fairy godmother just wants to help others and gets her reward from the joy she feels in seeing the person she is helping gain success in their life. The fairy godmother doesn't need glory. She is just doing what comes naturally to her. When we talked with Chaney, the school's out YMCA program worker, he shared with us that he learned about being humble from growing up with parents who encouraged him to work together with others and not to boast about his success. In his athletic life, this was reinforced, as Chaney had to be part of a team and knew that success depended on the team members working together, not as superstars out there on their own. Chaney also mentioned being humble as a good quality at work, since that also requires teamwork and everyone pitching in to do their share. I am sure that Chaney's family, teams, coaches, fellow workers, and employers appreciate his humble and positive attitude toward everything he does, and we do too. Thanks, Chaney. Our YMCA kids, Sophia, Allie, and Jillian, also spoke about being humble as a good thing. Sophia said that being humble helps in being a good friend to others. Allie said people feel bad if you boast and talk about how well you did or how good you are at something. Jillian said that she may think in her head that she did something well, but she doesn't say it out loud, since she doesn't want the other person to feel bad. If they didn't do well on a test or a grade in school, she wouldn't say anything. These girls are all well-liked by friends and teachers, so being humble is something that works well for them. Marley and Michelle, her mom, talked about being humble at home. Michelle helps her children learn how to interact with each other and share and help out. There's no one that's better or gets more than the other kids. They learn how to do good for other people in the community. They think of others. Michelle teaches her kids humility and sharing and caring. So when Marley comes to school, she tries to help other people. I notice Marley because Marley is always friendly. She's always helpful. She's always kind. She's humble. She doesn't talk about how great she did on a test or how fabulous her outfit is or anything like that. She's there to help others and be kind and sensitive. If there's someone that needs something, she helps them. And she doesn't want credit for that. She just wants to help. She's a humble kid. Our puppets told the story of King Midas, an old Greek myth, about a king who wished for lots of money so he could be more powerful. When he got this wish by being able to turn everything he touched to gold, he learned that the humble, simple things in life, the taste of food, or a hug from his daughter, were more important to him than all the gold in the world, and he ended up being a very lonely man in the end. Being rich in things or money doesn't equal being rich in happiness or love. You can't buy love. Pastor Mike spoke to us about not starting out as a humble person, but learning through his study of the Bible and training to be a minister that helping others and not thinking of oneself is what Jesus did. And Pastor Mike believes that Jesus makes a great role model of how to live a life of helping others. Pastor Mike also quoted Paul, who wrote many letters to new churches long ago, helping them to help others. Like Pastor Mike and Jesus, Paul didn't want any credit or glory for this. He just wanted to help others. He was humble, and that was good. So why do people choose to be humble in situations where they could boast and say how great they are at something or how they did better in school or work? It seems to be that the value of being a friend, teammate, coworker, or someone who can come alongside someone else, not in front of them, is a reward in itself. As our puppets illustrated, King Midas would have given all the gold he had for his daughter to come back to him. Her love was worth far more to him, but he didn't realize it until he lost it. Appreciating things that are important in simple ways, like love and friendship, means that your life will be rich no matter what thing you have or where you live. Being humble is a good character trait, and character matters. You can watch Character Matters here on HCAM on Thursdays at 6:30 p.m., Fridays at 5 p.m., Saturdays at 9:30 p.m., Mondays at 2:30 p.m., or online at hcam.tv/charactermatters. You never know who will show up. My name is Margie Wiggin, and I want to invite you to join me for my new show, Character Matters, on HCAM. We're going to talk about why do people choose the behavior that they choose? Why do they choose to be good? We're going to hear from people in history. We're going to hear from local heroes who make great choices. And we're going to hear from some puppets who talk about things they've seen, and they're going to say, "What? Did you see that?" "Yes, I did." Please join us.
How safe is that?
You asked them to follow some safety rules. Now they're asking you. Never let your gun get into the wrong hands. Always lock it up.